What's going on? It's Memorial Day, and I want to do something different than a hiking video. So I'm going to do a little family history. And I think I've spoken about my great-great-grandfather before, Captain Charles C. Battenberg, my grandfather on my father's mother's side. I'm here today at the Forest Hill Cemetery in Scranton, which is around the Dunmore-Scranton border. And I try to get out here Memorial Day and pay respects as he fought in the Civil War. So I'm gonna talk a little bit about him and give a little remembrance to someone who fought for his country. Hope you enjoy. Captain Charles C. Battenberg was born September 26th, 1841, in Hesse Castle, Germany. I'd like to read an excerpt from this book that I got. It was printed back in 1906. It's called The Genealogical and Family History of the Wyoming and Lackawanna Valleys, Pennsylvania, Volume 2. The book is filled with sections and paragraphs about people from the Lackawanna and Wyoming Valleys here in Pennsylvania. And since my family has been here for so long, I find a lot of mention of my ancestors in here. The section about Charles C. Battenberg has a paragraph about his time coming to the U.S. and being in the Civil War. And it goes as follows. He was reared and educated in Germany, and at the age of 16 years, emigrated to the United States, arriving in New York City, November 5th, 1857. He located in Dunmore, Lackawanna County, Pennsylvania, where he remained for 2 years, and then removed to Archbald, same state. He was employed by the D&H Company up to 1861, in which year his adopted country required the services of men to defend her integrity. He voluntarily offered his services and his life, if need be, that the Union might be preserved. He enlisted as a private in Company H, 52nd Regiment, Volunteer Infantry, and in April 1862 was promoted to second duty sergeant for courage displayed in the face of the enemy and for orderly conduct in camp. This was before Yorktown, Virginia. In January 1864, he re-enlisted as a veteran, and in March of the same year, he was commissioned second lieutenant. In the latter part of 1864, he was commissioned first lieutenant, and in January 1863, was commissioned captain and discharged as such in the same year. He was to the front during the severest fighting of the 4 years' terrible struggle and only received a slight wound to the left arm by the explosion of a shell during the 7 days' battle at White Oak Swamps. About 3 years ago, I was lucky enough to be able to take a trip down to Virginia to White Oak Swamps and visit the site of the battle where my great-great-grandfather was injured. So I wasn't exactly sure what to expect when I reached White Oak Swamp. It's now just a small bridge over a quiet country road in rural Virginia. And the only thing that would even mark it as being important at any time are a few of these markers and kiosks right along the bridge. The Union Army had gotten south of the Confederate Army, destroyed the bridge going across the swamps. These were a part of 7 days' battles. According to the information here, the difficulty in crossing and the decisions that were made here actually wound up being some of the most controversial of Jackson's career. Very interesting kind of side note to that. I also went over to the Malvern Hill battlefield, which is where those troops that were at White Oak Swamp fell back to and then continued to fight the Confederate Army. And this is just a small look at a portion of the life of my great-great-grandfather who fought in the Civil War. I'm lucky enough to have been able to find a lot of this information, and not everybody can find information on their distant relatives who fought in some of these wars. So I was very lucky to be able to find this. I hope that you enjoyed the video, and it's just a little way for me to pass on a little bit of the information about someone in my family who served the country back in one of its darkest times. Thanks for watching.